Καλησπέρα σε όλους. Good morning to everybody. All over the world, if there are a lot of people watching us via Facebook. We are in live streaming from Vica, Zagori, Epirus, the 1st of October 2021. We are very glad to have you with us and all the people all over the network. This is a special masterclass in the frame of Zagori Fiction Days, the second edition of Zagori Fiction Days, which is a festival and international meetings focused on books into TV fiction. And today we have a special masterclass about a kind of trying to adapt an Ismail Kadare's Albanian writer's book, which the title in English is The Ghost Rider, The Ghost Rider. In Greek, Pios Efere Ti Doruntin. It's about Doruntin's Balkan eternal legend, a Balkan legend all over the 12 Balkan countries. So, the music with which we began this special masterclass, composed by Giannis Galitis and accompanied by three colleague musicians. It was written specially for this masterclass and for the series to be shot and to be produced, The Ghost Rider. So it's a first try to do, to adapt in life, in the frame of a masterclass, a book of an Albanian, great Albanian writer, Ismail Kadare. We have with us a lot of people to take part, to participate. We have Vangelis Bekas, a Greek novelist and screenwriter. Ben Apolloni from Pristina, Kosovo. It's a premiere to have someone from Pristina, an artist and a screenwriter and a TV showman, because now he works more and more for TV cultural shows in Pristina. We have also Kosta Zhonga, a Greek Albanian citizen and artist, very well known in Albania because he produces, he makes a lot of TV shows focused on TV children. So he's a painter, he's an artist, and he teaches how to be an artist, how to really to be an artist for all Albanian children. His show is really very well known and in Albania and abroad. And we have, of course, Giannis Galitis, the composer, and three other colleagues. I don't know their names.
Alexis Tionis,
Ioannis Abanos,
Fotini Tsumani,
and Giannis Galitis. So, enjoy this special masterclass, which is shot in streaming. And also, we are going to show you in 2 or 3 days a special edited version of this masterclass. So, have a good day, a good masterclass, and we begin by the beginning. That means, what is this book of Ismail Kadare's, The Ghost Rider or Doruntin? I'm going just to say a few words about the book, and immediately after that, Vangelis Bekas and Ben Apolloni, they are going to really treat the treatment of this masterclass. The aim of the masterclass is to make, to see how screenwriters and directors work together to do something, the very first beginning of how we can adapt a book. How can we adapt a book? So, the book, very simply, is the legend of Konstantin and Doruntin. Konstantin is the brother of Doruntin, and it's an ancient Balkan legend that Kadare has taken, took and adapted à la manière de Kadare, his own way, his own way. It's a quite old book, successful all over the world. And it narrates another version of Kadares of Dorontin and Constantine legend. Very simply, it treats this book about how Dorontin, Constantine's brother, all of a sudden reappears in her village because she learned that a lot of catastrophes, a lot of bad things happened to her family. And everybody is wondering, how is it possible to have Dorontin back in the village, accompanied by her brother, Constantine, who was dead years and years ago. So the whole book and the whole story and the whole legend is how it is possible that Dorontin returned to her village, accompanied by a brother who had disappeared years ago. This is the whole story of the book and the legend. In the legend, we know a lot of things, but in the book, Kadare tried another version. He made another version. So that's what is it about, how we can do it, a TV series. It's the very first beginning of a workshop of people in the writer's room. They try to do something about that, which is a pilot of a TV series named The Ghostwriter of Ismail Kadare. So, Vangelis Bekas?
Say something, yes, of course. We have a lot of elements in our hands.
Yes.
Hello. Let's talk about this book and some thoughts about how maybe it can adopt it as a TV series. First of all, this book is the genre of the book is a mystery. It's like crime fiction, because Kadare take this legend, but he wrote a book like a mystery novel. His investigator is regional governor Stress.
Yeah.
Stress. It's easy because we have stress.
Stress.
Yes. He's under stress, and in crime fiction thrillers, the protagonist is under stress. The core of the story is to find out to solve the mystery, how Noureddin appears here, and especially. She said to everyone that her brother brings her from abroad, because Noureddin, let's say 10 years ago, get married in another country, away from the principality, because we are in Byzantium years, and there is a principality with a prince, where Constantin and Stres and Noureddin used to live, but 10 years ago they sent Noureddin away to marry some other guy. So the mystery, I'm repeating this, but this is the core of the whole story, and the whole narrative path is going to follow this thing. How is possible to get back by her dead brother? So the first thing is the genre, which is, as I said, mystery. If we were in America or somewhere else, maybe we could combine it with terror, because maybe we will have zombies and things like this. Because a lot of people in the book say that the brother came out from the world of the dead,
from a grave.
From the grave, and like a zombie, go to Bohemia and take his brother back. So the investigator, the story beginning like this. We are in the Byzantium years, and we don't have a phone call in the beginning of the novel, but we have a message that he's hearing about the news, and he should do something. So we are following his will to find out the truth. And this is the protagonist. And protagonist needs a film, a novel, and but TV series, to be honest, it's really familiar to have more than one protagonist. So we have, let's say, in basic dramaturgy, we have one protagonist. So this kind of book is stuck, not stuck, it's familiar with that kind of dramaturgy. So maybe it would be easier to adapt this book as a film.
Yeah.
Not than as a series, but our project here, and that we're talking about, is how we'll make it a TV series. So, we have a protagonist. I will follow the American way of thinking, which is based in Aristotle's poetics. So we have a protagonist who wants something to find the truth about Nureddin, but in studios says that it's different the thing that you want, and it's different the thing that you need. And you have a broken compass. There's a broken compass. So maybe our protagonist is going to find out the truth about what happened that day, that night, that the writer bring Nureddin back. But what is really that he needs to know? Maybe something, find out a new truth about himself, about the people, I don't know. You know, this this narrative path is common in many many myths or films or novels. This broken compass, but at the end of the whole story, we realize something, and this something is the core of the book. I'm going to be at the back of the book, at the last pages, where we find out that this core, this ethical element or purpose of human beings and Stremski himself is Bessa. Mm-hmm. Bessa. If you said something, you should do it. If you don't do it, you should be cursed. And not only you, like Constantine, all the society, because Kadare begin from the one and go to the whole of all of the society. Of course, we should remember that this book is written in 1986.
Yes.
So it was days. That what was the governor of Albania at that time?
I think Ramizania ishte president I Shqipëris. Në kohë nuk kur shkru
Ramizania për mëta.
Të ofë e gjënë. Në
mërë.
We have, yes,
still under
so we have East Bloc and the communism, realism and all these things. So these ideas are inside the book, but we would like to make a TV series in 2021.
Yeah.
We are after almost 40 years. So we have these two things. The one thing is that this book is written in a different era with different beliefs of the people, and also 20 years before the golden age of TV series. So our audience have great expectations, and the people, they have already watched so many things, so many great TV shows, so they want something more, something complex, not so linear. So we have a narration which linear, starts from the beginning. He has, of course, a lot of flashbacks and great mood and atmosphere from that past. But to be honest, we are in 2001, and we should try to make something more complex. Maybe we also, except from the protagonist arc, stress investigator stress arc, maybe we create some other arc of some other characters, and maybe and something more complex to create some relationships arcs. So in TV series, it's really interesting to find like planets, some characters. So we have Sun. The sun, our Sun is investigator Cross, but we have some other characters, and we should make a connection between them. And as episodes goes by, it's really interesting to evaluation and how can I say to transform this relationship in any way. As I read the book, I don't really mention it, mention something like this, because it's written in another way. It's more like Hammett's mysteries. It's classic novel. It's
like
not Dashiell something
Hammett, like Dashiell Hammett.
Yes, it's not postmodern or something.
No,
it's classic. So, for example, there are some things that mentioned in the story that we can use it. We found out in the page something that Stress was in love with Nureddin.
Nureddin, you mean Dorothy?
Yes, Nureddin.
Yeah, yeah.
Nureddin.
And it's
Nureddin, yes. Sorry. He says that he was in love.
Yes.
But we don't really.
It's a very good motif. This one, the incest, because they are brother and sister, but there are some signs that they were in love. So when. It's maybe it's good to.
You said yes, of course, and maybe we would like another microphone.
Okay.
Kosta, could you bring us a new microphone
so
we can
have a dialogue? Maybe it's better to do dialogue.
Yes.
It's, thank you. It's one part in the book that I like it's very much, and it's very interesting because Konstantin insists to marry his sister far away because they have something, they have some signs that are in love, and they don't want to have it. They want to be clear with each other, not to mess up. But so this is the motive why he insists to send his sister far away.
It's better far away.
Yeah, because if she is near, maybe they couldn't resist from each other. It's very interesting and very, I think it's very provocative, very and maybe this is the essence of the tragedy of this family. Dorothy and Konstantin, I have to say, it's the most beautiful and tragic story created from the Balkans. We don't know who is the first one who created the story, but it's the most tragic and most beautiful story I have read or heard. Because I grew up hearing my mother telling us as kids. It's Dorentina and Konstantin and their mother and their tragedy. But what is the essence of this story is
a given word, or how we call in Albania and in Kosovo, in Greece, besa. I heard you say besa.
Yes, especially here in Italy.
It's very important, and it's a very it's great value of the this part of the world. Yeah, and my mother always told us, if you give besa or you give a word to someone, you must
keep it.
Yeah. And you even if you die, you should came from the grave and keep the besa. And this is why I am very why I love this novel very much. And when we talk with Konstantin, what to do, what project, what book we should choose to transform into series, and when he mentioned Dorantina, I said yes, because he has some a lot of proposals. But when he says Konstantin and Dorantina, I said yes, this is it. And I would love to make, and I will work hard to create this this series.
So we agree. And thus. I believe that there are some flashbacks in the book.
Yes.
But in my opinion, maybe we will follow two parallel narrations.
Yeah.
The one narration, it would be present years, and the second one would be what happened 10 years before. Maybe, and we will have a. So, that thing, we can do it in many ways.
Yes.
That would be that 5 minutes we have one narration, other 5 minutes the other, and have a parallel narration. Or we can have two episodes or three episodes, and when we arrive in a dead end something, then we stop the narration there, and then go back. Okay. And so you can watch one whole episode in a different mood from 10 years or something ago, which narrates, begins for the first love sight of the two brothers, or the first hand, or something like this, mm-hmm. that catches her hands in a way, and all the procedures when he insists to send her away because he can't live with her and his and her husband in the same town, and afterwards that we can watch her marriage, and then that the nine brothers go to the war and died, and all this. That's all are some ideas, but let's get in mind that some flashbacks. We will recreate a new world, a new parallel narration, and we can combine. We can do other mm-hmm. things. For example, also Stress said that he loves that girl.
Yeah.
And I think that says one time, and never again we will meet this thing again.
It feels like they have something. When they meet after Dorantina comes back, mm-hmm. You can feel that Stress and Dorantina, they have one flirt or
yes.
they had before. So this is another good motive. And it's somewhere in the book is a part when suggests that the one who brings Dorantina is Stress himself.
Maybe.
Yeah. maybe it's not constantly, maybe it's very and creates a very interesting situation.
Let's remind who is stress.
Stress is the government, the investigator.
Investigator. Or Sherlock Holmes.
Astronomos Bekas by Zaitu. Yes, and so we have this romance there, and we have a conflict because Stress is married. He's a married man. During this procedure, he's getting stressed. Okay. Yeah. And his wife asked him how is he, and they have a relationship. And maybe this relationship get stressed, have problems when his wife realized that he's in love with Diredin. And maybe these things are not in the book. It's just
You can feel it. You can.
Yes, and when his wife was almost certain that he's going to have an affair with Nureddin dies. And we don't know. Maybe his wife is killed here.
Yeah.
That's not in the book.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
We can, in a way, we can play it.
Yeah.
We can. Fit this expectation kind of, the mind of the audience, mm-hmm. But never happened.
This is a suggestion that is suggested by Kadare's spirit, or it's your imagination?
It is suggested by the Kadare, but you should read very carefully to feel this. This motives, this details.
This is only some. This is a recreation of Kadare's imagination,
yeah.
Because he puts the elements,
mm-hmm.
But he's following a specific investigator. His novel is a mystery, so he's following what happened. He's not going a lot in the relationships of the protagonist. So. He's not writing a romance,
yeah.
Mm.
And all the things that we say now is some elements to combine mystery with romance, in a way. And there are some other elements, because conflict is something that creates drama,
yeah.
And Kadare talks a lot about, for example, the conflict between Orthodox and Catholic Church,
yeah.
And the conflict with the paganist people that
and
they believe,
the church, yeah.
Yes, mm. That they believe that someone came out from the dead, Constantine, to say all this. And afterwards, we find out that Constantine, when was alive, some rumors said that. He don't really like the church.
Yeah.
He bad mouthing them.
Yeah. Yeah,
all these things.
Scene,
yes, Kadare just said it once, but for us,
mm-hmm.
For
it's
us,
very important.
We can do a lot of things.
Yeah.
And something else, Kadare says at the beginning that the Knight brothers died in war. They go to fight the Normans, and died there. But after another scene. He said that these brothers, the two of them at the beginning dies in battle, but the other dies from plague.
Yeah.
Black fever, panolia.
Okay.
So, maybe it's an idea.
Okay.
We can use this thing,
mm-hmm.
And I say, because I'm an investigator too, Bekas, you know, but maybe we should make steps or stairs. So, for example, Kadare said that Nureddin and her mother dies at the same time.
Yeah.
But we have many episodes, maybe six or something.
Yeah.
So maybe, our first episode would have some elements about the relationship between Stress and Nureddin,
mm-hmm.
And I'm talking about the plus elements. We also have the basic mystery how she arrives here, but we also have the new one, which is more in our imagination, So in the first episode we find out about that when he was young he loves her, mm-hmm. and maybe his wife gets stressed these new reconnections, and at the end of the first episode died. So we said, what the fuck is going on? Maybe she killed her or something like this. And then during the second episode we learned that it wasn't just that her brothers died in the battle. There was blood, mm-hmm. and he's here. And everyone says that he was dead because of psychological collapse or something, or maybe his wife poisoned her, or maybe when one day at the end of the second episode. Her mother died, say, oh fuck, there's not all of this. Maybe there's plague again, there's something coming. And at the same time, the paganists, afraid of the plague, and say, and there is a conflict with the religion. It's a way to recreate the past and connect it with nowadays what happened. Of course, all this is ideas that use a lot of conflict, so get the dramaturg goes high,
yeah.
and we use also the ending of the episodes with hook.
Yeah.
Hook. Let's remind.
The term is if we are fish, and we would like to eat, then we have hook. Yeah. And give some cheese, not cheese for cheese. We use cheese for mice. Yes, which is what we choose for. What? Yes. Okay. So it's a way to trick you.
Yeah.
So that you get stuck with our story and wait until the next episode to see what happened.
Hitchcock films sometimes, because every time you find out something new, some new ways, some new doors to go in mysterious corridors. It's very interesting, very provocative Kadare treats religion and paganism. I like how he puts the mother is the boss of the family, the one who is most respectful. His word is law, and tells us part of our culture, because I think here in Balkans we have so many examples that a woman was respected, mother is respected, and is the queen of the this part of the families of I think this is a very good punch and direct into the religion, because when the religion came here, Christian or later Muslims, they don't treat women like in paganism, like before we used to treat. And I really love this part, and I would like to focus especially this part of the story.
So let's speak about maybe the personality.
So we have mourners,
yeah,
which
yeah.
are, it's like, yes, they say, they also sing the traditional story of,
yeah.
And that's happened in the grave, above the grave of Nureddin, Dureddin.
Δεν
είναι
το ίδιο.
Δεν
είναι το ίδιο. Δεν είναι το ίδιο.
Δεν
είναι το ίδιο. Δεν είναι το ίδιο. Δεν in Kadare's narration, there's a group of people, a group of with black clothes. But maybe we have one of her.
Yes, as in old antique tragedies, Coryphae, and even in even now in some parts of
that, it's the same.
Yes.
Like the ancient tragedy.
Because when I have read the Greek tragedies. And then I started to study more and more how they sing, how they work in play. I read Kadare has wrote one very beautiful book about Eskil and his tragedies. Eskil iki humbasi maus tu Eskil Eskilus. Eskil this. I don't know if it's exactly in English a big loser because he lost a lot of his work.
Yes, a lot of work.
Yeah. And if you read this book about Aeschylus, you can see how he wrote about the tragedies in Greek tragedies, especially Aeschyl, and the. Ceremonial about the dead people in different parts of Albania, in Greece, in Balkans. Yeah. How they cry, how they sing when someone dies. And I have seen some in some parts of Albania, a woman with black shamia. Crying in,
on the grave,
and saying, "Oh, you were so good. You worked in this place. You have done this, but all the time crying, and they made like one CV." But singing and crying, and I think this is very beautiful because story starts like crime story, like detective story, but Kadare adds these elements from antique tragedy, from Greek tragedy, and it's very very good, very very original, especially for. Other parts of the world, and this is why we think it's good and it's important to create a series or film. But more beautiful is to create a series in six or seven parts.
Yes, and I agree that we have the conflict between two worlds: the world of the. Of the principality, of the Byzantium and the Orth, which the heading figure there is the Metropolitan, Metropolitis, and who said to investigators stress that be careful, only one person can out of the grave of the death, and that was the Christ. Christ is God, and all the pagans. These peasant people that said that Constantine comes out from the grave is something that is against the religion, and that we will use our sword against them, and maybe we will use this conflict, this mood. Maybe we can show soldiers with swords because we are in the Byzantium here. Try to stop. These people, and maybe this is my idea. Maybe we have also the rumor of the plague. So we can imagine a village like this. Like this, I'm talking about the rocks, the way of the buildings and things like this. Maybe the mood is something like fog or something.
Yeah. And yeah, I see all because I'm also a director, film and theater director, and when I read, I find these visual elements, and I see all the time fog and rain and.
We have also this great storyboard. That Kosta the.
Kosta,
we would like to say some things about the story, Kosta.
Yes. Πάω το μικρόφωνο, λέγεται και σιγά σιγά, σιγά σιγά για να τα αναφράζω στα νυχτά. Αν είναι okay. We can translate after.
Yeah.
You can speak in English. In Greek. Ελληνικά.
Έρθε στην Κίνα να μιλήσει και ο ζωγράφος.
Φύνατα, φύνατα.
Έρθε στην Κίνα να μιλήσει ο ζωγράφος. Για συνήθως εμείς μιλάμε όλο μέσα.
Δείξτε.
Θα τα δείξω ένα-ένα τώρα.
Can I hold it?
Yes, I think that I recognize that person.
Zoom, right?
Zoom. Zoom.
Zoom.
Stress.
Oh, stress.
Investigator, stress.
Προσπαθούμε να βγάλουμε και το πρόσωπό του να έχει την έκφραση.
He's under stress.
Που δεν πιστεύει τίποτα.
In his face.
How the face.
And he believes, he don't believe anything. He's trying to find out the truth.
Είναι η δεύτερη εκδοχή τώρα που έχουμε να κάνουμε εδώ. Το σενάριο.
Yes.
Που λέμε που ο Κωνσταντίνος έχει πεθάνει. Είναι η μάνα του πλάι εδώ στο τάφο και...
The mourners and the Κωνσταντίνος mother who, who cries.
Μαζί με τις...
With the mourners, paganist women of the... Village.
Είναι αυτό που λέμε. Εμείς το έχουμε εδώ και στην Ήπειρο, είναι συνέχεια αυτό που λέμε με, το, με τη μαύρη μαντήλα. Έχουμε και επαγγελματίες για το κλάψιμο όταν πάνε στις κυρίες. Πάνε σε πληρώνουν αυτή τη δουλειά. Έχουμε... Παιδί είναι παράδοση πυρώτικη αυτή, δεν ξέρω γιατί στα Βαλκάνια αυτό. Εμείς το έχουμε εδώ.
They get paid to cry for in your funeral.
Και ο Κανταρέας το έχει βγάλει εδώ καλύτερα και εγώ προσπάθησα να δημιουργήσω αυτές τις τρεις επαγγελματίες.
How much they pay?
They do, it's their job to cry on the funerals.
Τι σαν σπίτια μας.
Εδώ μάλλον μας έχουν πέσει. Όχι. Είμαστε εδώ, τι με πέψαν τη σειρά. Ο Κωνσταντίνος που βγαίνει από το τάφο, μετά η μάνα της, μια εκδοχή που είχα διαβάσει, η μάνα πάει στα όλα τα σωστά όπως το παιδιών, άνταψε από ένα κεράκι και σε αυτό το Κωνσταντίνο άναψε δύο. Σε μια εκδοχή είχα διαβάσει που έκανε μια σαν μικρή κατάρα, γιατί δεν μου έφερε στην κόρη με την πάντρα μακριά. Για μένα περισσότερο πιστεύω αυτό που άναψε δύο κεριά, σαν ευλογία να μου φέρει στην κόρη. Και αυτός σηκώθηκε να πάει να πάρει την αδερφή εκεί που ήταν. Αλλά να πάει τόσο γρήγορα δεν γίνεται αλλιώς. Μόνο ένας νεκρός μπορεί να πάει όλη τη νύχτα να ταξιδέψει εδώ.
This is what the simple people believe, that Konstantin came out from the grave, and that's because his mother cursed him to go there and bring his sister back, like he said. He should follow the Bessa.
Yes, this is the what I wanted to. Sorry, Kosta. What I wanted to tell before, because he has given Bessa to his mother, and when you give Bessa to your mother, is something very special. You will give Bessa to the God. It's mother is like God in the family.
Και σε αυτήν την εκδοχή, όπως βλέπετε, το πρόσωπό του είναι νεκρός. Γιατί είναι αυτή η εκδοχή που είπαμε. Τη σημεία είναι η αδερφή που λέει, που είναι το ρουτίνα που πάει. Ήρθε ο αδερφός, γιατί δεν ήξερε που είχε πεθάνει, η πρώτη εκδοχή που είχαμε δείξει. Αυτή η εκδοχή είναι που είναι ο νεκρός, που σηκώνεται και πάει να την πάρει. Και αυτό το πρόσωπό του, τα χέρια του είναι...
Και είναι ζόμπι, Κωνσταντίνος.
Ζόμπι, Κωνσταντίνος, ακριβώς. Είναι μέσα σύννεφα.
What simple people believe the... The peasant, the paganist at that time, because we're talking about middle year.
Εδώ είναι που λέει ήρθε να με τηλεφώνησε να αδερφή στο σπίτι. Την άρχισε ένα λέει να πάμε σπίτι, ζητάει η μάνα. Αυτή η εκδοχή. Ξανά με αυτό το πρόσωπο και έχουν και την επιστροφή. Μέσα στα σύννεφα, που δείχνουμε ένας νεκρός, ζωντανός, ταξιδεύει με την αδερφή να πάει την αδερφή να κρατάει την πέσα. Και τι σημασία σε όλη τη ιστορία αυτό είναι, η πέσα. Συνεχίζουμε την άλλη εκδοχή μετά.
So, before continuing, let's have a real music break in the narrative. In the narrative, like we got serious.
Describe this.
Σαν να είμαστε στην ιστορία, να βλέπουμε το επεισόδιο και αφού περιγράφει όλα αυτά, έρχεται ξανά η μουσική και μετά θα μιλήσει.
Thank you.
Κώστα.
So Giannis, we just interpreted all of you something very special because the TV series, The Routine, was not still shot or produced. We imagined, all of us imagined that. And you tried to go far than that. I mean, just not only the masterclass, but compose the music like if it was really a pilot, like if it was a pilot. So, how you did that? How you worked this composition?
Θα μιλήσω στα ελληνικά.
Μίλα στα ελληνικά.
Για να τα πω καλά. Λοιπόν, η σκέψη ποια είναι. Καταρχήν αυτό που κάνουμε εμείς σήμερα εδώ, αν αναλογιστούμε ότι γίνεται από τον 9ο αιώνα μετά Χριστόν, μέσα σε τόσους αιώνες, πόσες φορές έχει υποθεί αυτή η ιστορία, πόσες φορές έχει τραγουδηθεί αυτή η ιστορία, πόσες φορές έχει αλλάξει ο τρόπος, τα πρόσωπα, τα ονόματα, ο τόπος. Έτσι υπάρχουν 157 εκδοχές διαφορετικές της ιστορίας. Η λογική ποια ήταν λοιπόν όταν μου έκανε την πρόταση ο Κωνσταντίνος για τη μουσική αυτή. Ένα πράγμα που αγαπώ πολύ είναι η κιθάρα. Ελπίζω να το καταλαβαίνετε αυτό. Η κιθάρα λοιπόν ήταν πάντα ένα όργανο το οποίο συνόδευε τη φωνή, συνόδευε το τραγούδι, το αρχαίγωνο τραγούδι. Μάθαμε λοιπόν να ακούμε μια κιθάρα και να τραγουδάμε. Εδώ λοιπόν γίνεται τώρα με τέσσερις κιθάρες αυτό. Ο σκοπός ήταν να τραγουδήσει και η παιδική χοροδία, που στο ενδιάμεσο μέρος θα μιλούσε όχι τόσο για το έργο, αλλά δεν θα μιλούσαμε για κανένα έργο αν δεν υπήρχαν πόλεμοι, αν δεν υπήρχε κακουχία, αν δεν υπήρχε αυτό που συμβαίνει γενικώς. Άρα λοιπόν, ο πόλεμος είναι αυτό που γεννάει αυτό που συζητάμε εμείς και αυτό που συζητάνε εδώ και αιώνες. Η ιδέα λοιπόν ήτανε, και θα σας δείξω λίγο και την παρτιτούρα, γιατί δεν είναι μια συμβατική παρτιτούρα όπως γνωρίζουμε, με νότες κτλ. Αφήνει τον έλεγχο στον κάθε κιθαριστή να μπει μέσα στην τραγωδία αυτή, να καταλάβει το κείμενο και να αρχίσει από μόνος του με ευφυή έτσι σχήματα να προσδιορίσει τους χαρακτήρες. Άρα λοιπόν μιλάμε ότι η κάθε κιθάρα είναι ο κάθε εμπλεκόμενος μέσα στο έργο και λέει τη δική του εκδοχή, τη δική του ιστορία όπως ο ίδιος ίσως την έμαθε, ίσως την άκουσε ή ίσως πιστεύει ότι είναι. Η κάθε κιθάρα λοιπόν ξεκινώντας με αυτό το αργόσυρτο στην αρχή με τους αρμονικούς που φτιάχνουν αυτό το ήχο, που είναι το ξημέρωμα της μέρας της συγκεκριμένης που συνέβη αυτό, διηγείται λοιπόν η κάθε κιθάρα, ο κάθε άνθρωπος διηγείται την ιστορία του. Με τον τρόπο αυτόν λοιπόν που διηγείται ο καθένας, θα λέγαμε ότι και στην ιστορία έτσι έχει δείξει η ιστορία, ότι πολλές απόψεις συμπίπτουν. Υπάρχουν μικροδιαφορές, αλλά υπάρχουν όμως και σύμφωνα πράγματα. Άρα λοιπόν, παρόλο που ο καθένας έχει τη δική του γραμμή και τη δική του άποψη, όλα αυτά κάπως αναμπλέκονται μέσα στον χρόνο και να βγάζει το αποτέλεσμα αυτό. Άρα δεν υπάρχει κάτι προσχεδιασμένο, μάλλον υπάρχει ένας αυτοσχεδιασμός προσχεδιασμένος. Υπάρχουν σχήματα τα οποία θα παίξει ο κάθε κιθαριστής και ανάλογα με το χρόνο που του δίνεται, μέσα σε όλο αυτό, σαν θα λέγαμε μέσα σε μια κατάσταση τρανς, παίζοντας, αν αυτό το έργο το παίζαμε τώρα για ακόμα μισή ώρα θα μπορούσαμε να το παίζουμε και για ακόμα μία ώρα θα μπορούσαμε να το παίζουμε. Μέσα λοιπόν σε αυτό μπορεί να βγουν στοιχεία τα οποία ένας σκηνοθέτης μπορεί να τα πάρει και να πει αυτό θα μπει εδώ. Άρα αυτά συνέχεια αναγεννούνται. Συνέχεια βγαίνουν καινούργια πράγματα μέσα από αυτό. Και είναι υλικό που μπορεί να αποτελέσει, ναι.
Just a minute to, yes, to translate the essence. Giannis Galitis composed the music, distributed four roles. Every guitar interprets his own role in the story, like if it was one guitar narrating one version of the story, the second version. They they seem to be the same, but they have difference from one another. So he composed the partition of the music, the sheet of the music, really like one motif, one structure, and from this structure, the director, or the showrunner, or the screenwriter, the showrunner, can take whatever she believes that it could fit to the story. This story, of course, and not another story. Yeah. So he composed like if it was one piece of music autonomous, okay, independent, but in the same time, because of the routine. So he was in the story, his background, their background, and after that, he made a structure, quite open.
Και μέσα σε αυτό γεννιούνται τραγούδια.
Yeah.
Δηλαδή, έχουμε ένα δείγμα τώρα ενός τραγουδιού που μιλάει κατά του πολέμου. Είναι,
okay.
Το οποίο θα μπορούσαν να γεννηθούν μέσα από το στίχο του Κανταρέ, μέσα από το σύγγραμμα του Κανταρέ, τραγούδια που θα συνοδεύσουν κάποιες στιγμές συγκεκριμένες. Πάντως, το ηχόχρωμα θα μπορούσε να ήταν αυτό, παρμένο μέσα από αυτό, διάφορα σχήματα και να μπορούσαν να επενδύσουν έτσι κάποια επεισόδια.
Also, the structure is open enough. Take extracts, pieces, but also he composed a kind of song, like in a lot of series, we have some songs, more and more, film and series, both short, where the song plays a capital role, an essential role. And so you can, like in the film movies, you can keep that, this song, not this melody, this song, I mean. So, Kadare and Kadare inspired, Kadare's book, The Routine, inspired Giannis, because of all the beliefs in the background, the war, the conflicts, and the paganism, the religions, the conflict of religions, like something who could inspire him and inspire him to make also a try of, to compose a song also. So, open structure with music and open structure to maybe compose songs. He composes. We are going to take our discussion, your discussion about the script, and afterwards we are going to maybe listen also some other extracts of that, where we can see that he opens different paths to the music of the TV series, because now TV series are more and more sophisticated, more and more complex, and music in TV series, it's now maybe the key role, the music is the key role of the series more and more. I mean, series shot in America or in Europe, where the musicians, the composers are asked to make a great effort to produce a music that is open, with motifs, with songs, with excerpts of songs. And people like that more and more. So, musicians are asked to be very present now, more and more in TV series. And the knowledge and the great series, seasons by seasons. So, okay, we can continue.
Can I ask something?
Yep.
How do you think part of the women in crying at the grave of the Constantine to treat this? Have you think about this thing? Because I think it's very interesting for music.
Yes. Θα μπορούσαμε να χρησιμοποιήσουμε, πώς θα κάνεις μετάφραση, την κιθάρα ως κρουστό, ως σώμα. Έτσι, ανακαλώντας λίγο την αρχαία τραγωδία, έτσι, ως η κιθάρα έχει τη δυνατότητα πέρα από τις χορδές της να μπορείς να κάνεις και άλλα πράγματα επάνω. Οπότε και ως τύμπανα, τα τύμπανα του πολέμου κτλ. Κτλ. Μπορούν να πλησιάσουν αυτό μαζί με ένα τραγούδι.
Μεταφράζει στα αλβανικά. Okay. So it's a body, the guitar, like a body, and you can play the guitar normally, but you can also play in another way the guitar. You can imitate other things, like the symbols of the war, a lot of things. He sees that from his own point of view. He is a musician, he is a composer, so we can see in the TV series if the musician can propose new things and these things to be accepted. It's not all in all cases that accepted, but more and more we have sophisticated series European more, but American also, who have music play a first role. We have a TV series, Trema, a very good series, shot in America, by David Simon and George Pelicanos, scenario, where Trema, it was how music could survive after the great typhoon of America.
It was 10 years ago. Is very important part of the process of creating the narratives of the film or theater. I know I have read about other directors, but I know from my experience, sometimes I heard some good music and it inspired me to create a scene, to create some. It was I think it's very important. Music isn't just in the background. I think it's a very important part of telling the story. In great films, in great theater pieces or series, it's important. It's like dialogue, like camera movements and other things.
We're just beginning, in the beginning of how music can be radical in the TV series. It's the very first beginning. Because we know the conflict between showrunners, directors, movie directors, series, and this, and the writer's room. Well, the writer's room, they have a very important word to say. It's their word. So, TV series, it's not like movie, but now musicians, composers, can play a new role, I mean, to be more radical, to propose their own vision. We'll see with the series, maybe this
David Lynch, which is, we all know David Lynch, but the most important of him is that he was the man that came from the, the art house films, and he created Twin Peaks in, ages
you
ago.
Mean, David Lynch.
David Lynch.
David Lynch. Twin Peaks, it's a reference.
David
Lynch. And musicians and TV series.
Yes, and all we remember all the theme of the Twin Peaks. And I know that David Lynch, I'm talking about this director because he's not snob about TV. And he's also recreate a new.
He changed the TV series.
Yes,
completely, radically.
And he, when he direct his films or Twin Peaks or his TV series, he's also listening music in his ears.
Yeah.
And he play music for all the crew. So the crew cuts the mood of the film because it's really important, the TV series, and we say that this TV series is good because it has a mood. It's not just talking people.
The mood is very, very important in this book and this series.
That's David Lynch.
Yes.
Unique. Twin Peaks. It's a reference.
And he's or also he's a composer himself.
Yeah, of course. Yes, it's not by by chance. I mean, he's musician, he's composer also.
A painter.
Painter, yeah, a lot of things. A lot of things. A unique example.
So let's go to the other. The other version of the.
The other version.
The
yes. Wow.
Μ' άρεσε πάρα πολύ.
Χαίρομαι.
Συγχαρητήρια.
So let's
συνεχίζουμε το...
Just translate to English, after that we continue. So, Kosta Zhonga says that all over he was listening to the last music interpretation of Giannis, where he was thinking about this... the two brothers, the brother and the sister, just ghost riding, and you can have that 10 minutes, 5 minutes, 1 minute, or 2 minutes, that's very nice.
Και όταν γράφει ένας, είναι λίγο πιο περιορισμένο. Οπότε η ιδέα ήταν και δεν είναι σύνθεση, είναι μία σκέψη. Τη μοιράζεσαι με άλλους τρεις ανθρώπους και αυτοί οι τρεις άνθρωποι δημιουργούν την ίδια στιγμή. Άρα είναι συνθέτες.
Ναι.
Έτσι, αυτό.
Now, it's important to say that this last remark because Giannis says that this is not a real composition. It's a proposal of thinking. It's a thought that you're sharing. Of course, I have to say, by professional point of view, that if you pitch the project like that, about a board of professionals, very strict, very well structured, very, you know, I put money or I don't put money, what's he saying, this guy, I'm selling my music, you have to be a very special pitching to say that. So, it's a very nice idea, you share that, but when you pitch the project and you and the director, the producer says, okay, let's hear to your music. First of all, you have to convince that it's your best music, it's the best. After that, depending the background of the producer, if he's quite cultured, you say that. If not, you're lost. Okay, that's good. But we hope new generation of new musicians and new showrunners and new directors is going to emerge, and they are open to hear that, these kind of things. Which is very well, I mean, thought, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it's very, very, it sounds very, very beautiful, very...
Okay.
The first thing is, the first thing is to believe in the mini-series and not only doing soap operas and things like this. Because, yeah. To be honest, in Balkan, we don't have many great mini-series. We have a lot of mini-series in so other countries in Europe.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about America or Israel.
Yeah.
I just saw Babylon Berlin.
From Tom Tucker.
Yeah. But it's great. I think Earth and Netflix are great.
They broadcast it. Yeah. Yes, Babylon Berlin.
So it's important, first of all, to understand that we have this new kind of TV shows that, is, of course, it's broadcast, of course, it's TV, but we'd like to closer it, to have another belief of film. Another belief. So, if we're thinking like this, and the producers and the TV stations believe like this, and there are not a lot of people that believe like this, then we will achieve, or we are at last, how can I say this, believe at the same time that music is really important for the... For the TV series, because nowadays in soap opera in Greece, when we would like to dramatize a scene, we just find out a music that we believe that it would be something that would increase conflict and dramatic, and just put it. So it's a way of thinking that TV shows is not something that. Women above 60 watts on the screen while they're doing the dishes or cooking, or they can. I remember that they said that we write dialogues in TV shows like theater because people may don't watch. They can do some other things, so they were away.
And just listen.
Just listen. But that's changing. And we should follow it and think the way that you talked before about music. Like TV series is real art, and there's a combination of all this. So we could see the other.
So now the other version. The other versions that Kosta designed. For us, in storyboard.
Ναι, πριν θύμισε να δείξουμε το τρίτο version, να δείξουμε. Ήθελα να πω αυτό που είναι τη συνεργασία, αυτό που λέγαμε, η συνεργασία μεταξύ του συγγραφέα, σκηνοθέτη, του συνθέτη και του ζωγράφου. Γιατί το storyboard είναι πολύ βασικό. Mm. Πολλοί νομίζουν, και σκηνοθέτες που έχω γνωρίσει και στην Αλβανία, νομίζουν είναι κάτι απλό, έλα, εγώ δεν πειράζει. Mm. Αν χάνουν χρόνο περισσότερο, γιατί αν δεν έχουν ένα storyboard, να ξέρουν να δουν τα πλάνα, τι θα κάνουν, που η δουλειά του γίνεται πολύ πιο γρήγορη, πολύ πιο εύκολη και πιο οικονομική. Γιατί μου έχει τύχει να πάει ο άλλος γυρίσματα, χωρίς storyboard, να κάνουμε αυτό το πλάνο εδώ, κάνουμε και κάνουμε και τα βήματα, μετά δεν κάναμε τίποτα. Λέει. Mm. Και μετά τα ξανακάνω όλα. Αυτό είναι χάσιμο χρόνο και λεφτά που ξοδεύουν. Γι' αυτό πρέπει να συνήθως όλα να πούμε. Ο Spielberg έχει κάνει ταινία χωρίς storyboard. Ξεκινάει από την αρχή μέχρι στο τέλος. Jurassic Park έχει κάνει όλο storyboard. Νομίζω ότι άλλοι. Που αυτό τι κάνει. Έχω προσέξει, έχω δει τον Spielberg που είχε κάνει. Γιατί δεν ξέρω να ζωγραφίσει. Πολλοί σκηνοθέτες λένε: εγώ δεν ξέρω να ζωγραφίσω, πώς θα το κάνω εγώ. Πώς θα δείξω. Και με συνεργασία που είχα με πολλούς σκηνοθέτες. Με απλά, με γραμμές, σαν ξυλάκια τα κάνω, όπως με τα σπίρτα που γίνεται μια φιγούρα, έτσι ο Spielberg, το κεφάλι αστρόγγυλο, γραμμές, το πόδι, χέρι, αυτό, το δει στο ζωγράφο, του εξηγεί αυτό και μετά το δουλεύει ο ζωγράφος αυτό, είναι η δουλειά του αυτή, που τα συνεχίζει. Αυτό το προτείνω σε όλους σκηνοθέτες να κάνουν ένα storyboard, να συνεργαστούν με ζωγράφους, είναι, είναι ομαδική η ταινία, δεν είναι γιατί να γίνει μόνος του. Δεν είναι με ταινία, θέλω αέρα, μπήκα εγώ μόνος μου σήμερα να κάνω μια ταινία, πάρω την κάμερα, να τα κάνω οικονομία. Είναι μια ομαδική δουλειά. Όλοι μαζί να βγει κάτι τέλειο. Τώρα συνεχίζουμε, γιατί ήρθαμε στο τρίτο κομμάτι της Δωροντίνας, που είναι το κομμάτι που λέει η Δωροντίνα, την ιστορία της, που λέει ήρθε ο επιχειρηματίας που δούσε εικόνες και του δείχνει τα προβλήματά της. Που έχει τη μάνα να τη δει τόσα χρόνια, το αδερφό, είμαι μόνιμη εδώ. Γι' αυτό είχαμε κάνει αυτό το πλάνο που αυτή βγήκε μπροστά σε αυτόν να δείξει, να πει τα χάλια της. Να το πούμε και έτσι. Και αυτό στεναχωρείται. Να σα πω. Εδώ είχαμε ένα κοντινό πλάνο. Πού επιχειρηματία θα το πούμε καλύτερα.
Είναι η τρίτη εκδοχή που δεν αναφερθήκαμε εμείς πριν. Εδώ, δεν είχαμε φτάσει ακόμα στο σημείο, είναι προς το τέλος.
Είναι το πρόσωπό του που είναι λυπημένος με αυτά που ακούει. Και λέει να τη βοηθήσω, να την πάρω μαζί μου, να την πάω. Και αυτή, αυτή τη στιγμή αυτό κάνει, πάει σπίτι και γράφει ένα γράμμα. Στον άντρα της. Είναι έγραψε ένα γράμμα. Okay. Έγραψε ένα γράμμα, λέει, το αφήνει το γράμμα για τον άντρα της να δείξει που φεύγει. Αυτή γράφει που φεύγει με τον αδερφό της. Γιατί αυτοί ξέρουν, αυτό νομίζανε. Και αυτό είναι που ταξιδεύει μέσα στα βουνά, είναι αυτή η εκδοχή. Στο τέλος, που ταξιδεύει μέσα στα βουνά. Και σε αυτό το πλάνο το τελευταίο είναι με μάσκα. Mm. Ο λόγος ποιος ήταν, γιατί βγήκε στο τέλος που όλοι εμείς που είμαστε οι Κωνσταντίνεδες.
Mm.
Που φέραμε την Τωροντίνα, καθίσαμε την Πέσα. Yeah. Είναι η Πέσα. Τώρα ζωγράφος τα είπε με τα.
So, yes, the mask is because the.
The mask is because
at the end of the story, we find out that Bessa should. Everyone should follow it. And is an obligation in every member of the society that if someone, one of us, give Bessa and something happened to him or not following the Bessa, then we should do it for him. So. The mask man is everyone of the society that would go there and follow Bessa. In my imagination, because I'm trying to think the TV series more complex, I Kadare said of the beginning of, in the beginning of the novel that the mother of Doruddin sent three messengers, and the two of them. Didn't succeed to send the message, and the third one was lost. No one knows who is he. And in my imagination, say, oh, maybe we should use this element because in the film, the seller of the Orthodox icons was not the real person that bring him back. they tortured him, and he said that yes, I did that, yeah. But he didn't really did. So I like to use the women with the black, and maybe this third messenger goes there, but he was a drunk. He likes to drink and use all the money that Father of Nureddin gave him to spend it in horse or something like this. But during this procedure, he may have, second thoughts about it. And don't feel guilty that he don't even try to go to the message. And he's trying to... it's from Shakespeare, this kind of masking. Mm-hmm. And maybe he, during the procedure of... the women with the black, he didn't like himself, and he dressed like the women, so try to not show his face that he was the messenger. So maybe for me, it's one of us that do the job of Constantine, and that's why he's wearing a mask. It's an idea. Mm-hmm.
One of us, the spectator.
One of the one of the society.
The society.
Yeah. Yeah. Because in the book, Kadaré has a speech. Stress. All the people get together, and he's make an announcement speech that he was going to say who is the real.
The
ghost rider.
Yeah.
And he said some. He said about this ethical aspect, Bessa, but it's. I think that it would be more interesting for a mystery novel to visualize it in a new protagonist. This maybe. This
in the novel and in series, we should treat specially this motive. Who? Who bring the Dorantin? Because we all know she lost all her brothers, her mother is in pain, mourning, but it's tragic, it's sad, but what is interesting now is because the mysterious way she came back at home. This is the one of the ideas that we can focus on the third messenger.
Yes.
Yeah. Or in stress, because I find some elements that stress and Constantine are very similar, even as a figure, and it confuses people, even if they
say David Lynch. This is David Lynch.
Yeah.
Yes, so,
it's Kadare. I met him, and when I told I am. Then I am a filmmaker, and told me, oh, I wanted to be a filmmaker. The first, because in Albania it was on list of ones what you want to study. The first one he checked was filmmaker. The second one was for literature, and in bureau, I don't know who. Thought Kadare is for literature, and they sent him to. But he wanted very much to be a filmmaker, and I have seen in many of his works filmmaker's spirit. He is very good in telling story, how
he's very visualized.
He's very, very good in this. And when you read, you can imagine very easily what he means, what he thinks.
Yes. The narration step by step, with scenes, with mood of the of the atmosphere, of the places, the setting, the setting, and then dialogue.
He never forgets to write about the moon.
Yes.
And it's interesting. He's from Albania. From in Albania is warm, always sunny days. Mm-hmm. But in his works, maybe more than 90%.
It's raining.
It's raining.
Yes, it's like Angelopoulos.
It's like Angelopoulos. It's another place in his mind. Mm-hmm.
So, what at this point of the workshop, what can we keep from the book? We are in a writer's room, we are discussing, Fred discussing, okay, what we are going to keep or not, are not going to keep, what can we imagine, what can we add, respecting the spirit, but we are free to adapt. When we say adaptation, we are free to adapt. We keep just the basis. So, what can we keep, what we cannot keep, what is useful, what is not useful, to make a mini series, it's a mini series.
I believe that we will keep everything. Because, yes, maybe not in the same order, but we will use everything because it's not a big book.
Yeah.
Okay, so, and there are a lot of scenes, and there are episodes in there, but if we'd like to create something bigger, it's useful to use some ideas. Maybe he has only one scene with how Stres was in love or flirted with Durantin, and then we said, we will use three-act structure in this relationship. So we have the beginning of this thing, we will have the middle of this this relationship, and the ending of the relationship. And we will use it in many aspects of the novel. For example, we have another relationship which could be interesting with the Metropolitan, the head of the church. That he met with investigator Stress and told him what things. This is something illegal. This is something bad for religion. The belief of Constantine came up from the dead. And that is the start of his relationship. But after this, we can have some steps, some scenes that show that in the beginning they agree. Then we have the second step that there is a legal conflict. Then we realize that Stress don't really starting not like the Metropolitan and starting doing things without mention on this to try to hide what he's really doing. Maybe in the five step the Metropolitan knows about it, but don't say it to the Stress, and maybe goes to, we have another officer who helps Stress with the procedure, and he's reading the archives of the family and things like this. Maybe the Metropolitan goes to this person and say to him, I will give you his, you would be the next governor, the next inspector if you help me, because religion is above all, and Stress don't know about this. And maybe this conflict between the Metropolitan and the Stress become a conflict, an inside conflict between Stress and his
assistant.
And maybe you know, we create steps and scenes that create an arc of the relationship and make something like and connect all this in the basic narration, so that we'll have six series and
six episodes.
Six episodes. Yeah. Sorry, and but to be honest, that is something that we can't be certain and sure on in an hour.
Yeah.
Okay. All these are ideas, and we have to put all these ideas in the paper and to talk about it and to see, oh no, this is not useful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or this is, it can't fit with the other. Because if do this, we can't do the other. But I believe that we should have one main story, would be the story of Kadare, stress trying to find what happened. Yeah. And we should have also two stories, and it's common in series to have one main and two subplots, we say in films, but there are some other stories that's coming parallel with the basic and going like this. So we should be really, will recreate these two stories. Mm-hmm. Maybe the one is the love story.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And the second one is what happened with the Metropolitan and Orthodox and the conflict between paganists and Orthodox. Yeah. Maybe this. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Maybe the next time we meet together, someone have another idea and said, no, this is better. Mm-hmm. And boom. Yeah.
At that moment, you can ask someone if he has another idea to suggest about the two girls from Macrome. Maybe you have an idea about how can you imagine other stories? Is it modern enough? Is it old enough? Is it useful? Can a Greek spectacle can watch that in another way, or it's just for Bart and general people? I don't know, because we have to take to consider the spectator also.
Mm.
We are talking that to make the most pragmatically nice, good, useful, and avant-garde. I mean, okay, in some frame. So, but we have to consider the spectator, not only the Greek one, but the Balkan ones, another. How this book, which is, it's not special, it's a great book, it speaks of a lot of things, but it's not local, it's also very global. So how can we have a really good TV series, Balkan thinking, Balkan speaking, Greek or Albanian, don't know, but being for abroad, being for a large audience, being for a platform, not just only for the small Albanian, Greek or Serbian TV, for abroad, something could appeal really foreign people, an American, French one.
Something to have a universal appeal.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a love story, and so I also talk like a spectacle, Well, it's a love story, first of all, isn't it? So it's universal. And then you have the horror story, which is also universal. So it depends on the way you write the dialogues, I suppose, and on the editing, and on your cast, and of course on the money sometimes, the money you have to spend, actually. But I think it is universal. I mean, it will involve audiences all around the globe, no matter the language. Mm-hmm. And it's something about keeping your word, like you meant, like the best, I think. It's not only, I don't think it's only Greek or Balkan, or I think it's precious. I mean, something like about keeping the word to your mother or to yourself. That's what I think. So it depends on your pitching, of course, as always. And I think it has a very good chance of being funded and screened around the globe, in my opinion.
Very good, thank you. So BESA for an English speaker, BESA for Americans.
It's keep the word.
That's the thing.
At any cost, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the trouble. You have to go a long way to keep your word.
Yeah, that's very good. That's why maybe some very good British series of Channel 4 or BBC can touch us why Downtown Abbey touches us, not because of the old things, but it's a really very strong story, and it's how we can sell the best thing to foreign producer or a Greek producer, like I said, it's just giving you what, nothing more, more or less. That's good. So, very very good.
If the English audience, yes, and spectators understand that at the beginning of the film that they have a protagonist that try to find something, that he's an investigator, they catch it from the beginning because they know it's their culture in a way. It's in their culture. The mood would be different, maybe the language.
Yeah.
And after this, if we have the romance to combine it, this is also a universal world. Anyone can understand. And especially if the spectators and the audience is, how can I say? Never mind, I'm not going to say that, because maybe it would... No, I wasn't. But if you combine crime with romance and drama,
yeah,
then you are everyone knows that.
Yeah.
And then because the locality of the crime romance story would be that everyone abroad said, I saw a film. I watched the film from the Balkans. They are in Middle Ages or something like this. That would be the different. Mm-hmm. So it would be something old, but in a new way. Mm-hmm. And that's the secret. The people that they create the TV show says that this is the secret. You shouldn't do something experimental because we're talking about a lot of people that we're going to watch this show. So we will use elements to remind them something old, crime, romance, and things like this, in a new way. And our new way is the Byzantium and the legend.
To find the connection between the old time, old ages, and now.
And nowadays.
Yes, because we can find, for example, crime, a woman crying in the graves, or Bessa, or I don't know what else, but it's very important when we watch or when we read the history, it's to find the connection between us and before
the past.
Yeah, the past. Yeah,
the past. Yeah, before the past. Yeah, that's very good. So, if you...
Well, it's time for dancing.
Well, yeah, why not? The thing is,
no.
It was. It is a very first beginning of a masterclass. We can imagine we are in a non-typical, non-official, unofficial writer's room. Okay, and we have a book. You had a book. And the question is, okay, the beginning is, what can we keep? What we cannot keep? What are going to be useful? What elements we are going to mix? We are the very first beginning. Before opening the writer's room, we have the script, and we have three, four writers who are going to take parts of the script to write, and we have a showrunner. So it could be a mini series. I resume now. I resume the pre-writer's room, and would it be 4, 5, 6 episodes? We don't know.
I guess. Yeah, we don't know yet. We say something about 6 or something.
Very, very well. Okay. And maybe not the difficulty. The originality would be that it is a Balkan story. Okay, it's a Balkan legend. But maybe it would be good to have collaborations from 2 or 3 or 4 countries together. I mean, writing. The Serbian one, the Kosovo one, the Albanian one, the Greek one, because it's common.
It's a common legend.
So, we could have an opportunity to have more than one writer, more than one language. That would be a creative difficulty, I mean, to do that. So, this was the first the first effort trying to have together people from three different countries, very close, Greece, Albania and Kosovo. Kosovo with a special story, we know, now independent state, again, you have to tell that. And Kosovo feels that much more than the other countries, because it's half recognized all over the planet, so they have still to struggle against a lot of diplomacy, things like that, a small country, and they maybe feel more than us the necessity to open, to travel and have their ideas. I mean, yeah, I don't say that because Ben is there, but because I visited Pristina and I felt that. They have a very good theatrical scene, very vivid, very creative, but they cannot go outside and travel and show their things. So anyway, the thing is that a writer's room of three, four more Balkan writers together to write something really good, effective, serious, which goes abroad, it's that asks not only money, but will, a good will, to have all that together.
Yes.
We don't know till now examples of this kind of writers' room. Generally, it's Greece narrating all the other points of view. The Serbian, the same thing. The Serbian, it's Saturday, tomorrow, we are going to have this discussion. The Albanian also, the thing. So things just to combine, to find the ideal mixture, where everyone accepts. Say the rule is just writing, not politics, not things like that, but writing and open and what else. So let's hope that it was the first beginning, the first step to do that, and next time to step more and more. I have to say that this masterclass was thought in the beginning as a 2 days masterclass in Albania, in Tirana and Pristina. Oh, it's serious bargain, we are going to do that. Next year, in 2 days, it's a real. Well, it will be a great show, TV show. Okay, integrate like that, but really, really shot like a TV show, during 16 hours. Not a marathon thing, but really, we are in the writer's room, we distribute roles, and we have a lot of people who, and the public who takes part and says, what can we do also as spectator? So we are going to try that next time. We are going to inform you in time how you can do that with Albanian TV and Pristina TV, okay? And let's say that people watching us or who are going to watch, so they are going to appreciate this effort for the first time. So thank you, everybody. Okay. I think we.
I want just to ask everyone in this room. Story starts in the morning, but I see all of the time as a knife. Mm. How do you see? Because I don't see light, sun, day. I don't see the story goes during the day, just in the night. But I don't know about you, the others.
Someone else. Yeah, we talk all the time.
I really want to know about.
Maybe
this,
just say something. In dramaturgy, we have peaks and lows in a way. So maybe we'll use dark for dramaturgy peaks and for the positive aspects of our when we will achieve when we're going to a dead end or something. Then we have black. We have night. When something shows us that yes, we will solve this problem, or yes, there would be a romance, something good, maybe we have a little light. Because it would be six episodes, and we have all the time dark. Then
it's normal to find but, this to
but maybe
think about this. But I don't know why I don't see light
not
at all. It's all dark, it's all at the night. I don't know why. Maybe I should read more and more. And
yes, but if
think
we use
more about this,
if we use a little light, then
you can
we
put
will
colors in the dark. You can put colors in the dark.
If we see, if you watch in the dark all the time, then we forget the flavor and the beauty of the dark. So we will use, in my opinion, light just to remember how important the dark is.
Yes,
in this way I'm talking.
Because it's
it's winter time. Or September, October.
Yes, I think it's on this time.
Yes,
this
yes.
time of the year. But in my head is all the time dark.
Yes.
Story. Everything, you know. Even if there's something between love story, I see it in the dark. Unë e pita se në anglisht me pashë, unë e shok krejt në gjarin, e se kur fillon në gjarja në mëngjes. Do në tanë zhvillot gjatë ditës, po unë e shok të gjithë në natë, nuk shok dritë asë një... Pak dritë për një.
Ήρθα από εκεί στο report που θα κάνει, είναι όλα νύχτα. Να πεισώ να έχω κρατήσει και εγώ αυτό το ασπρόμαυρο.
Όλα νύχτα.
Όλα νύχτα.
Όλα νύχτα.
Γι' αυτό έχω κρατήσει στα όλα. Είναι περίπου ασπρό με λίγο φωτισμό. Κίτρινο που έχω κρατήσει λίγο. Όχι στα όλα. Εδώ είναι ασπρόμαυρο εντελώς. Αν δούμε όλα τα πλάνα, τα καρέ που έχουμε φτιάξει, είναι
μαύρο φόντο.
Είναι μαύρο φόντο, είναι νύχτα. Γιατί όλη αυτή η ιστορία περίπου γίνεται νύχτα. Και όπου ταξιδεύουν και όπου κάνουν, όλα τα πάντα είναι νύχτα. Γίνεται πολύ ωραία ιδέα αυτό. Φαίνεται ξεκίνησε η δουλειά να γίνει από τώρα.
Σωστό, γίνεται night. Αρχίζουμε τη νύχτα και τελειώνουμε τη μέρα. Μπορεί η μέρα και κάνουμε νύχτα.
The, of course, we can do anything. The conflict between us is if we use only dark,
yes.
Or we use some light to reinforce the dark.
Okay.
We're going up in the. Never mind. I think that this procedure is later on.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
And it's it has more with the director and the mood that he would like to create.
Excuse me. What do you prefer, natural light or?
In this story, not natural light. Yeah, I think it's very theatrical.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's my belief too.
But I don't like, for example, to treat Konstantin like Frankenstein. Because, like American horror movies. No, it's more mysterious. We just can watch open the grave. Because it makes more mysterious.
Yes. Yeah.
This is the point of the.
Yes, yes.
So not a zombie. Not a zombie.
It's a classic novel, and you should treat it like you want to.
But with a theater atmosphere, or like old German movies, expressing German
stories. Okay, thank you a lot. So rendezvous next time, Christina and Tirana.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you a lot.
So you will start to learn Albanian because I'm learning Greek.
Besa, guitar. Necessity. And our musicians also. Yes. Pristina is a far away, but for Tirana, yes, okay. Pristina is a long trip to go.
Long trip.
And maybe we are going to need a visa as Greeks to go to Pristina.
Oh,
yeah.
Maybe, I don't know. Εμείς δεν
τους έχουμε αναγνωρίσει.
They need visa, we don't need visa.
And that is a question in production,
yes.
For example. If we don't believe that Kosovo is a country, then what's going to...
But business is business, and individual is individual.
But we have a cultural diplomacy too, so it would be useful to have.
They can ask for that tax rebate.
In which countries we
will buy big production house.
It depends on
who found.